In this tutorial, we are going to go over how to create a quiz using iSpring Free. I have already created my course in the familiar PowerPoint environment. I did everything I would normally do to keep my course interactive and engaging, including using animations, transitions, triggers, and hyperlinks. It's usually a good idea to add quizzes towards the end of your course, but you can add knowledge checks throughout if you like. Now that I am ready to add my quiz, I will begin by inserting a blank slide. Now, select the Quiz button. From here, you can insert an already existing quiz by selecting Browse, or create a new graded quiz, or survey here. I'm going to create a new graded quiz today. Free Quiz Maker offers you three question types: multiple choice, multiple response, and short answer. If you want more options, the full version of iSpring Suite offers 14 question types, including drag and drop questions. I am going to create a simple three-question quiz using each type of question, starting with multiple choice. Type your question here. Now you can fill in your answer options below. Add additional questions by typing here, and select the correct answer by checking. Down here, I can make changes to the feedback given on correct or incorrect answers, as well as adjusting what each question is worth. Over here, I can enhance my questions with pictures, videos, and audio. I'm going to add a picture to this question by selecting the Picture button and selecting an image from my desktop. There, that looks good. Now I'm ready to add multiple response questions. I will select the Question button and choose Multiple Response. The question is a version of multiple choice, but your students will be able to select more than one correct answer. See how I can select both of these options? I'm going to adjust the feedback for this question as well. Now I'm going to add an image for every answer of the question. See how I've selected the Picture button beside each individual question? This way, the correct photo will be associated with the correct answer. Lastly, let's add a short answer question. Again, let's type our question here. And down here, you can type the answer to your question. Of course, you can add additional answers if you like by typing here. And again, let's change our feedback at the bottom. Let's keep things looking good by adding an image to this one as well. When you are happy with your quiz, click Save and return to course. The quiz will appear on your slide as a placeholder. Before I publish, I'm going to take a quick look at the preview to see how my quiz will look on different devices. Now I will just move down to the quiz to see how it looks and use these buttons here to show how it will look on different devices. As you can see, the quiz layout adapts depending on the screen size. Okay, this looks good. Now I'm ready to publish. I will name my course and choose an output folder, and if I wanted to publish to an LMS, I would come down to this tab here. I'm all set, so I will select Publish. There, now that my course is finished processing, I'm going to view it and see how my quiz looks. It looks good so far. All my PowerPoint effects are working perfectly. And if I select the menu icon, I can navigate directly to the quiz. Now, here is my quiz. You can see my multiple choice question with the image beside it. The user will receive feedback on correct or incorrect answers, and they can click on images to enlarge. When the quiz is finished, your student can view results or go through the quiz and review the answers. And that's how easy it is to create a course using iSpring Free.